In this question, we are asked to find our rate law and our rate constant, and we'll go over how to find the correct units so you don't lose any points in your next test. Hello everyone, I'm Melissa Maribel, your personal tutor, and these are the formulas you need to know. That first one helps us find X and Y, so you can plug that into the second formula because that is your rate law formula. Now this question gives us a table that shows three different trials: the concentrations of our reactants A and B measured in molarity, and the rates of each trial measured in molarity divided by seconds. We'll use this formula to solve for X and Y, which are the reaction orders. Since there are two unknowns, we will pick trials 2 and 1 because they have the same values, which would cancel out and we would be left with just one unknown, which is Y. So we will divide rate 2 by rate 1 and plug in the values for each reactant A and B. Next, we can cancel out like terms so the K's cancel and this entire term cancels out. When we divide the left side, we get 9. And when we divide 0.6 by 0.2, we get 3. That 3 still has an exponent of Y. And since 3 squared is 9, then Y is equal to 2. Let's solve for X using the same exact process. But this time, we will use trials 3 and 2 since reactant B does not change, and this time that will cancel out. When we plug everything in, we get this. We can cancel the K's and the Y's, and when we divide the left side, we get 1. Dividing 0.4 by 0.1 gives us 4 to the power of X. Now for this one, remember, anything raised to the 0 power is 1. So X must equal 0. Replace the X with 0 and the Y with a 2, and we will get this, but remember, anything to the 0 power is 1, so our actual rate law only includes reactant B. But wait, don't forget about your rate constant. We must use the rate law to find the rate constant K. Using the known values in the table, we will plug that all in. Since all our numbers in the table follow some sort of pattern, then it does not matter which trial we use. In this case, we will use trial 1 and plug in the values. Square the 0.2 and the unit, and we will get this. Divide over that 0.04 to both sides, and we get this value. But we need our units. You know, I always see students getting marked off for these units, so let's find our units separately. This is where we left off. This m squared is actually divided by 1 and can be rewritten as such. So we are dividing fractions. When dividing fractions, you must multiply by the reciprocal of the second fraction. 1m cancels and we are left with 1s and 1m on the bottom, which can be rewritten to m to the negative first and s to the negative first. So this is our rate constant with the proper units. Now what happens if the given values in the table don't follow a pattern and you're left with decimals? That example and explanation are in this video. Make sure to check it out. All right guys, I'll see you over there.